Good morning, students. So welcoming to the next online video class, children. How are you all? So I hope all are fine. Good. Have you prepared that last class portion, children? Say yes or no. So what are the things we had completed the last class? Very good. Vegetative reproduction. So there comes under in two methods, children. One is natural method. The last class we had prepared artificial method. Am I correct? This artificial method. Artificial method means, so there they comes under in one of the two major methods. One is conventional method and another one is modern method. Isn't it? Modern method means, I said there is the laboratory. So that is related to plant tissue culture through micropropagation. So that's a laboratory we are creating in a one of the advanced technology we can use in intensive plants to produce a spore numbers. That's known as modern method. Conventional method means, so we are using in a large, very long time we are using to produce in a vegetative propagation methods. Okay, that's a method is called a conventional method. Clear, ma? This conventional method is, they comes to three types. Is it clear? What are the three types, friend? Please tell me. Tell that answer. Cutting, grafting, and layering. Isn't it? Cutting, grafting, and layering. Then we have completed that. What do you mean by cutting? So from which plant part we can use for cutting, isn't it? So these are the cutting types we learned. Root cutting, stem cutting, and leaf cutting. So these all the things, isn't it? Then after that, grafting. What does mean by grafting, children? Will you say the answer? Tell me. Yes, good, very good. The grafting means, so there two different plants we can join it to produce a one plant. Clear, ma? Say so, no? So that's here called as, the name is known as grafting. So there we can use it in two parts. What are the two parts? One is scion and another one is, very good, stalk. Clear? So very good. Yes. Next one, the different types of grafting. Will you say that is the types of grafting, children? Very good. Bud grafting, approach grafting, tongue grafting, crown grafting. Crown grafting, another one names also there, isn't it? Cleft grafting, okay? Cleft grafting and wedge grafting, isn't it? So these are the things only we had prepared and we had learned in that previous class. Is it correct? Yes, good. So today's class we are going to learn about, this is the conventional method. The last type is the layering methods, okay? What do you mean by layering? The layering means, first one, the stem of this parent plant that is allowed to be developing in that is a root, so that one is in that, it is contacting with the soil region. Okay? Above, that's a root region. When the roots are they developing and then in that root region, at that time, after developing the root, we can cut out that part. That is the growing in a new plant species. Ah, that's a new plant. That's we are called as, the name is known as layering. Tamil layering, padiyavitta. Clear? That's a layering means, that's a very, very important one plant. So we can use it in the stem of this. The stem is we can use it in the parent plant. So when that's a root or developing in the stem, that's a touching of this region, the soil, they touch that part, the stem region, there they produce in a root. So at that time, after that, we can produce that roots of this parent plant. Immediately we can cut that plant and then that's the plant only they growing to produce in a new plant species. Understood? So that's the type, that's a type is we are called as, the name is known as layering. Clear? So this is comes under one of the conventional method of, very good, the conventional method. method of vegetative propagation in the higher plants. For example, the snaring method is very effective for the jasmine. Did you know this? Yes, good. The next one is soda. So these are the some of the familiar plant species we are using in that layering method. Understood, children? Yes. So here, this layering method is, they comes to two types, children. One is mound layering and another one is air layering. Clear? Mound layering and air layering. What do you mean by mound layering? Mound layering means, so this is the method, so that's the flexible branches there. Okay? So we can choose in that is the flexible branches, children. So this flexible branches, the lower part of this with the leaves also we can select. Okay, that's the lower part, that's the leaves is there now. That one is just to be bended to the ground regions. Okay, all of you look this picture, children. So this is the lower part of this twigs we are selecting. So this is the lower part of this plant means, so they are present in a leaves also. Okay, just that's a flexible in nature. So just we are bended to this is the stem part into the soil. Then above the tip of the portion is they growing in its upward direction. Understood now? This is the stem regions only, whereas the they touching to the soil. Understood? Then after what will happen means, so here this is the buried part of the stem, there they emerges in that a root. Clear? After what will happen means, so we can, so that is get it in a new plant. From this is the parent plant, this is the lowest, okay, from this region we will cut it and we can get it in a new plants. Understood ma? After this the development of this root, the stems are buried in the soil, that region is only developing the roots. Clear? After we will cut this is the region, we can develop in, or we can get it in a new plant species. Understood ma? So this is the method as we are called, as the name is known as mound layering. Understood? Then next one, what do you mean by air layering? Okay, what do you mean by air layering? So this is the method, all of you look this second one. This is the method, first that's a nodal region, we can removing the bark or gridding of this nodal regions of the plant. We must selecting that is the nodal regions of the stem, degrading, I mean removing the bark of this. Clear? After the second step, what will happen it means, all of you listen, what things we can do means, so this is the removed bark now, that's the removing of this griddled, so make it in, this is the node region now, that region we can apply in the hormones. Why we can apply the hormones in that regions means, so that can be induced to promote it, that is a root. Clear? So that's why we can induce it, that is a certain hormones. Understood? Now some of the root growth hormones are there. So that's the things we can apply in this the griddle area of this nodal regions. Understood? Then after we can, so take it in one of this polythene cover. Inside the polythene cover, we can add it in a damp or just moist soil. Clear? So that soil, let's take it and then use with that tape. So we can tie it properly. Understood ma? Say yes or no? Yes. Good. Then after, so that is the 2 to 4 months. Okay, so that takes time to developing in that root, children. Right? So after we can leave it sometimes. I mean, so that is the 2 to 4 months later. So they produces that is the roots. At that time we can remove. I mean, so this is the plant. We can cut it from this is the parent plant. That one they developing in that is the new species and that new plants. Understood now? So this is that the new developing plants we can get. After we can, if you want means we can grow it in that is the pot, or if it is, if you want to plant it in that is a soil mix, so that is a ground region, so planted this plant, that one is they growing in that is the new species or new plants. Understood now? Say so now? This is the air layering. that air layer means first we can select in the system the griddle of this nodal region. That's very, very important. Okay. That nodal region, first just remove that bulk. Okay. Then after that is the region, we can apply some of these hormones. I mean hormones means the root promoting hormones. Okay. That will induce, that's the region. Then after this is that area, we can take the rest out of the polythene cover. The polythene cover inside there, so the field, that is the damp, or that is the very, that is the moist soil. Okay. Then after that is the tied that properly, if we can leave sometimes. After, if we are looking in this 2 to 4 months later, from that region the roots or emerges. Okay. The roots are arising. After so this, we can remove, that is the branches, so we can get it in a new plants. Understood now? So that is a new plants. If we wish, we can grow it in a pond, or that is we can use to growing in, that is the ordinary, that's a ground region. Understood? This is the one of the layering method of air layering. Understood? Say so now. Yes. Next one, we can complete the conventional method. The conventional method means we know that thoroughly, that's the three parts, isn't it? What are the three types you learn it? Very good. That's the three methods of cutting, layering, and grafting. These three methods related, we are going to say about, that's the advantages of conventional method and another one is disadvantages of conventional method. Clear now? What are the advantages? So you know very well of these three methods of conventional method of vegetative reproduction in higher plants. Understood? Will you be able to say few advantages of this conventional method of vegetative reproduction? Try to tell children. Very good. The conventional method, first, let's say plants are producing means, that's the gene characters are very, very similar, and that's uniform gene character. Genetically, the plants are, they produce in a uniform. Understood? Huh? Next one. So we can using this is the method, very short period we can produce in a many numbers. The number of the species what we can produce in, that's a very quickest method. So this is that one. Clear? Next one. No seeds are produced. Suppose if you need to produce in a little seeds also, so that cannot be germinated. So this type of the plants we can produce in, this is the method. Okay, that's one of the good method we can produce in a, either that is no seed. Suppose that's a seed also presents with little, the type of the seed is there. Otherwise, the seeds are having also not germinated one. Okay, so these are the varieties of the plants we can producing by this method. This is one of the advantages of conventional method of vegetative reproduction. Understood? The next one, if we are choosing some of the economically valuable plants, okay, that plants also we can using for, this is the conventional method of vegetative propagation or vegetative multiplication or vegetative reproduction. Okay, that's one of the good examples, potato species, Solana tuberosa. Okay, that's a binomial name for potato, Solana tuberosa. Then you know that very well about, that is the grafting. Grafting already I said. So we will choosing in a two different type of the plants. Is it correct, children? These two different type of the plants. So if one plant is having the desirable characters of disease resistance capacity, and another one plants is they producing in a higher yield. Okay, these type of the varieties we can using this grafting method, we will get it in a very good. We will get it in a one of the good item. That's we can produce in a good varieties. Okay, that's the purpose only we can using in the grafting method. But what is the major use for this grafting method means? So we will get it in a, so that's the desirable characters. The desirable characters means, what's mean by desirable characters? For example, disease resistance character, high yield, and sugar content increase, iron content increase. These all the characters are, they comes on a desirable. desirable characters. These desirable characters, they present in a different plant, but we are creating this method of this vegetative propagation. We will get it in a single plant, we are getting a desirable characters. Understood now? This is the another one advantages of this conventional method of vegetative propagation. Clear? Then disadvantages means, that's a very important one of this. It's a point. First, the parent plant, suppose that is any of this, I mean suppose the virus diseases is in having in that is a particular parent plant means that is producing in that is the N1 or offspring, that's the same virus diseases as they produces in a, that's the N1 also. Understood? The new plants are producing at the same, that's the characters they produces in the N1s. That's one of the disadvantages. Next one, if we produce in the vegetable propagation, that's a more numbers means, that's not easy to maintain and then not easy to store. Okay, they occupy that more spaces. So that is another one disadvantages of this, the vegetative propagation of this conventional method of propagations. Understood, children? So these are the some of this advantages and disadvantages of vegetative reproduction in plants. Understood? The first one, overall idea about this artificial method. Artificial method is they comes under in a two types, right? One is conventional method and another one is modern method. The conventional method is they comes to that is the three types, right? What are the three types? First one is cutting. Very good. The next one, layering and then grafting. Yeah. So these are the three types of this comes under in a very good conventional method. Understood, ma? So here, that's the grafting is very important one of this type of this reproduction method, the vegetative reproduction method in plants. First one, they comes to that is the five different types of the grafting is there. Bud grafting, approach grafting, tongue grafting, crown grafting, wedge grafting. So these are the some of the types of the grafting methods. The next one, layering. Layering also they presents in a mainly two types. One is R layering and another one is mound layering. Okay. Then total, overall we want to prepare this one of the final question. What are the advantages and disadvantages of conventional methods? Understood, ma'am? Say yes or no, children? Yes. So this is the vegetative propagation is over. So that is the asexual reproduction, asexual method of reproduction. It presents in a lower form of this organisms and also there is the lower plants and then higher plants. Okay. Next, we are going to learn about there is the next stop, next topic. We will start with a little bit of portions only, children. That's a sexual reproduction. What do you mean by sexual reproduction? Very good. So here, the productions of gamete, okay, and then the fusion of this male and female gametes, after that getting in a fertilization process, isn't it? That is that former, I mean, so that is the event is, so that is the production of this and formation of the gametes, that is we are called as, the name is known as sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction means, so the first one is the production of this gamete, after that fusion of male and female gametes, so that's the fertilization process. So this all the process that form is called as, the name is known as gametogenesis. Okay, that's the processes we are called as, the name is known as gametogenesis. Okay, first event is, so there is the formation or productions of male and female gametes. Understood? Then second event is fertilization, the fusion process. Okay, the male and the female gametes fusion, that's we are called that's a fertilization. That is the second events for this sexual reproduction. Understood, ma? First one is production of male and female gametes. Then that is the first event. Second event, that's a fusion of male and female gametes. That's the second event is fertilization. Clear? So these are the two events that take place in a sexual reproduction. If you are looking in this is a sexual reproduction, that's a lower plant snakes. Lower plant snakes, you know that very well, isn't it? Will you say this is the examples of this lower plants? Algae, bryophytes, fungal organism, isn't it? So these are the plants when they comes to very good. So that is the lower plants. These lower plants, they are also, they take place in a sexual reproduction. Okay? That's a sexual reproduction. So that means what? That's a gametic fusion is present. So sometimes there is a motile or immotile form of this plant species. They involve, that is the fusion of this two type of the gametes. Understood? So these two type of the gametes already, we know that 11th standard we had learned, that's a second chapter, algae. So there is their presence in this algal species, that's a sexual reproduction, that's a type of this gametic fusion as they come under in an isogamy, anisogamy, oogamy. Do you remember that? Yes, very good. That's the three major types of gametic fusion, that is comes under in a sexual reproduction in algal species. Understood? No? Don't forget this one. Okay, so that one. This type of the lower organism, I mean lower plants, such as, so that's the algae, bryophyte, this is the takes place in that external fertilization process. Okay? Then if we are looking in the higher plant species, this is the fertilization as the internally happens. Understood? No? So that's the higher plants, it's a fertilization as internal one. And then it's the lower plant species, so that is the fertilization process that takes place in externally. Understood, children? Say sir, mama? Yes, good, very good. The next one we are going to learn about, this is the sexual reproduction in plant side. First we are going to prepare, that is a flower. Flower means, you know that very very important one of this part. They produce from their plants, isn't it? So there is the multi-dimensional properties they have. Some of this they are using in, that is a decorative purpose, and then as we can using in, that is some of this very effective fragrance preparation, isn't it? Then some countries flags also they are embedded in, that is their flower, isn't it? So multiple purpose we can using in, that is a flower. The next is, my question is, what do you mean by flower? What do you mean by flower? So if we ask this question means, we are going to say this is the answer. The flower is the highly condensed shoot. That is, the condensed shoot means very very shortened of this shoot axis. There, for that reproduction function, for that reproduction function, there their shoot axis, they very much reduced, then after finally they produce in a flower. That's the definition. Clear? Flower means very condensed, very very shortened axis of the shoot, they modified to developing in the distal for that reproduction function. That's we are called a flower. Very very condensed of this shoot means, so there is the shoot is the series of node and internodal part is very much reduced in, that is the shoot axis is present. Understood, Bob? Yes. Then you know that very well, that's the essential part of the flower. What are the essential part of the flower and what is the non-essential part of the flower? This is also you had prepared in your 11th standard portion, isn't it? Morphology. But parts of the flowers means, you are all on, you know that scalyx, corolla, andrecium, gynecium. So these all the things are they comes to very good. That's the parts of the flower, isn't it? The non-essential parts means calyx and corolla is they comes to the non-essential part. Okay? Then that's a very very essential pole, or that is a reproductive pole means, so there comes under an andrecium and gynecium. Am I correct, children? Say yes or no? Very very important and essential word is the antecedent and the venition. Okay. First one. So here, for that sexual reproduction, they are involving in a certain process. Okay. Such a process, they takes place in the higher plants. So some changes or some of the process for that sexual reproduction, that's the higher plants, they takes place in the three stages. Clear, ma? That three stages are, first one is pre-fertilization, fertilization and post-fertilization. Understood, children? First one, pre-fertilization means you know that and the development, and then that's ovule formation, embryo sac development. These all the things are they comes to, that's the pre-fertilization. Next one, fertilization means the stigma and pollen grains, that is the fusion of this gamete. So these all the things are they comes under the fertilization. So there only diploid version and trigamete. So these all the developmental stages they comes to fertilization process. Clear? Then post fertilization means, so there the formation of this endosperm and seed development. Clear? These all the things are they comes under in a post fertilization. Okay? So these three major areas children, let us learn that one by one in that next class. Okay? Today's class, so all must prepare. This is the conventional method of vegetative reproduction in higher plants. So you must mention in the three type of this. I mean, first one is cutting, grafting, layering. These three things together you should prepare. This is the 5-mark question. And also yesterday I said that is the one of this very very important types of this grafting methods. Clear, children? Bud grafting, approach grafting, that's the answer. The next one, the same 5-mark pattern. What is the advantages of conventional method and the disadvantages of conventional method? Sometimes they will ask, it's a public in your public board of examination. Mention any three advantages of advantages and any two disadvantages of conventional method of vegetative propagation. Understood, children? Yes. Next one. What does mean by sexual reproduction? That is, we can prepare that. So, 2-mark question, what do you mean by gametogenesis? Okay, children. The next one, what are the process takes place in the higher plants in sexual reproduction? The three stages. Just you learn this is the names of pre-fertilization, fertilization event, and post-fertilization. Okay, children. Thank you, students. Thank you very much.